Vein with lowest oxygen saturation. A. Coronary sinus. B. Saphenous vein. C. Renal vein. D. Femoral vein. Correct answer: A. Coronary sinus. Oxygen extraction is maximum in the coronary circulation, so that coronary sinus is the vein with lowest oxygen saturation. So myocardial oxygen uptake cannot be increased much by increasing the oxygen extraction as done by skeletal muscles during exercise. Thus, oxygen extraction reserve is low for the myocardium compared to skeletal muscle. Myocardial oxygen uptake can be increased by increasing the myocardial blood flow with exercise. Unlike the skeletal muscles, which have only low oxygen demand at rest, myocardium is continuously at work even at rest, needing a higher oxygen extraction. Renal vein has the highest oxygen saturation among the systemic veins in the body because renal blood flow is much more than that needed for the metabolic needs of the kidney. Renal blood flow is about 1/5 of the cardiac output and is meant for the filtration of metabolites through the kidney. Because of the oxygen saturation of the renal vein, suprarenal portion of the inferior vena cava has much higher oxygen saturation than the superior vena cava at rest. But with exercise, as the blood flowing from the femoral veins become more desaturated due to the higher oxygen extraction by the exercising lower limb muscles, inferior vena cava saturation drops. Saphenous vein oxygen saturation is also dependent on the state of the lower limb muscles dropping with exercise due to enhanced oxygen extraction. True about bivalirudin: A. It is a synthetic 20 amino acid polypeptide. B. Inactivates both free and fibrin bound thrombin. C. Useful in HITS. D. All of the above. Correct answer: D. All of the above. Bivalirudin is a synthetic 20 amino acid polypeptide which interacts bivalently with both active catalytic site and exocyte 1 of thrombin. It inactivates both free and fibrin bound thrombin. Bivalirudin has a short half-life of 25 minutes, which confers a potential safety advantage. Half-life may be increased in renal failure. Bivalirudin is useful in HITS, heparin-induced thrombocytopenia syndrome, when continued anticoagulation is required. ISAR-REACT 3, REPLACE 2, EQUITY and HORIZONS AMI trials have shown the efficacy of bivalirudin. Lowest risk SQTS genotype: A. KCNH2, B. KCNQ1, C. KCNJ2, D. None of the above. Correct answer: C. KCNJ2. KCNH2, KCNQ1 and KCNJ2 are the known genotypes of short QT syndrome. Of these, KCNQ1 mutation has the highest risk and KCNJ2 the lowest risk of cardiac events. It may be noted that the genetic mutation of most patients with SQTS is unknown. Flecainide is a class 1A antiarrhythmic agent, B class 1B antiarrhythmic agent, C class 1C antiarrhythmic agent, D class 3 antiarrhythmic agent. Correct answer: C, class 1C antiarrhythmic agent. Flecainide is a class 1C antiarrhythmic agent. It has also been used as a challenge in suspected Brugada syndrome to unmask ECG changes with a small risk of precipitating ventricular tachyarrhythmias. Commonest mechanism of bigeminy: A. Escape capture bigeminy. B. Echo bigeminy. C. Block bigeminy. D. Ectopic bigeminy. Correct answer: D. Ectopic bigeminy. In ectopic bigeminy, one sinus beat is followed by an ectopic beat and a pause. It will be a full compensatory pause if it is a ventricular ectopic beat. The pause will be shorter in case of supraventricular ectopic beat. This is because the sinus cycle is reset by the supraventricular ectopic beat. In echo bigeminy, an atrial or junctional ectopic gets conducted down through the slow AV nodal pathway and returns to the atrium through the fast pathway, producing an echo beat. The echo beat in this ECG has an inverted P wave in lead 2, indicating retrograde conduction to the atrium. Junctional beat has no P wave. In escape capture bigeminy, a sinus pause is terminated by a junctional escape beat and is followed by a sinus capture beat. In ectopic bigeminy, pauses after the ectopic beat, while in escape capture by Gemini, the pause is before the escape beat. The sinus capture beat has an upright P wave in lead 2, indicating antrograde conduction. Here is another ECG illustrating atrial ectopic beat marked in blue color, followed by atrial echo marked in red color. Here both P waves are upright with different morphologies in the given monitor lead. In block by Gemini, the pause is due to the non-conducted beat. It could be either a 3:2 sinoatrial block or 3:2 atrioventricular block. This means that for every 3 P waves, there will be 2 QRS complexes in case of 3:2 AV block. This is the last set of MCQ series for the current year. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel for future updates and click on the bell icon for all updates. Thank you.